So, the title is You Are What You Eat, for my persistent speech, referring to healthy and unhealthy diets. And, well, in the U.S., it says that about a quarter of 2 to 5-year-old kids, school children, are overweight, and about 1/3 of other schools are overweight for school children again. And they say about 2/3 of adults, more than 2/3 actually, are overweight. So, I guess we all have one body, and there's a saying, basically like, treat your body like a temple, and then wouldn't you only want to store treasures into your body? And it goes on, and then, since we have that, like, the freedom to store treasures, we have like the freedom to treat however we want it, to treat our body. So it involves about exercising and eating healthy and having a healthy diet. So for me, like I hate feeling sick, I hate being tired, and you know I'm tired all the time. And so I try my best to maintain good health and by consistently exercising and preparing homemade meals, which is so difficult. Like when I first started, I would forget some days and end up just driving to Burger King or McDonald's. So these are some problems that occur with an unhealthy diet. Heart diseases, obesity, type 2 diabetes, colon cancer, depression, and nutritional deficiencies. So I believe that if we live a healthy diet, it will only benefit us. It will give us a tendency of living longer and being less vulnerable to these diseases right here. So first I will explain heart diseases, then I'll explain type 2 diabetes, and finally offer a solution to living a healthy diet. Now I'll explain heart diseases. So heart diseases, what is it? Well, according to Mayo Clinic staff, it's a cardiovascular disease generally refers to conditions that involve narrowed or blocked blood vessels that can lead to a heart attack, chest pain, or stroke. So blood vessels are blocked by blood clots, which is just dried up blood within the bloodstream. And the blood vessels are narrowed by fatty plaque, which is, cholesterol built up in fatty substances, which it all, like, in the picture shows the veins connecting to it. So these veins will be getting blocked. And then they say heart diseases is like a silent killer. So you could be arguing with someone or screaming at your kids or something, and all of a sudden you'll get a heart attack, and you wouldn't know if it's coming. The causes. So heart diseases are caused by smoking, drinking alcohol, excessive caffeine intake, drug overdose, and high blood pressure. I'm only going to talk about high blood pressure because it involves eating healthy. So high blood pressure is when you're eating improperly, and to really heal it is just adjusting your lifestyle. So now I explain heart diseases, and now I will touch up on the type 2 diabetes. What is it? Well, diabetes, you're either born with it or you can get it, but eating improperly. So type 2 is when you eat improperly. So according to website diabetes.org, diabetes is a problem with your body that causes blood glucose to rise higher than normal. So this is when you get insulin resistance, which is when insulin isn't being processed correctly. So first the pancreas creates too much insulin, and eventually it can't keep up and can't create enough. Which here the diagram shows that the glucose here just builds up within the bloodstream and starves the cells without any energy. So it affects your eyes, your kidneys, your nerves, or your heart. Causes. Sugars are probably moving within the bloodstream. Glucose is building up and the cells are being starved without any energy. So it's when you're not keeping your blood sugar in range and you're becoming overweight, or when is it eating all food groups or eating too many calories. So first I explain heart diseases, then explain the type 2 diabetes, and now I'll offer a solution. So what foods to eat? I remember growing up in elementary school, they'll teach us about the 5 groups of food. Vegetables, fruits, proteins, grains, and dairy. Well, according to Medline Plus, when you have type 2 diabetes, taking time to plan your meals goes a long way toward controlling your blood sugar and weight. And Mayo Clinic also include that these include eating a low-fat and low-sodium diet. Someone with type 2 diabetes will be as, like, a doctor would recommend a diet, which is difficult to have or difficult to come up with on your own. And for like someone just trying to maintain good health, it says healthyeating.org says, for each meal, divide the plate into approximately 4 quadrants. lean meats, beans or nuts, grains, fruits, and vegetables. Add a glass of milk or include a serving of cheese or yogurt, and you have a complete meal. So I guess we're told to eat about 3 meals a day, and it says to maintain good health, you should eat about 2,000 calories per day. For everyone, it's different. I myself try to eat about 3,500 calories a day, and yeah. And exercises. Well, like, as I was going through it and looking around, it says that we should at least work out about 30 minutes a day. And that includes walking or running, or full body workouts that you can do at home, such as push-ups, pull-ups, squats, and all those crunches. Or just being in any activity. Playing sports, going hiking at least once every 2 weeks or just once a month. Or just playing with your kids or with siblings, younger siblings. So I like this word, the heart is a muscle, and it only gets stronger and healthier if you lead an active life, which I really thought. And what I do, I personally am trying to gain weight, so all I eat is chicken breast, rice, and green beans. Like every day, it's so boring. But every now and then, after workouts, I drink protein shakes, and I'll eat like a bunch of peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, because I love those. And then I have a cheat day every couple weeks. So cheat days are actually really healthy because it speeds up your metabolism. Because if you eat all these, the five groups, your metabolism starts to slow down. Exercises, I work about 1-2 hours a day. I hardly do any cardio, I hate cardio. And I only lift weights. I used to play sports, I played football in high school. And dancing, I love dancing. I go out every now and then, I go dancing, I know how to do salsa, cumbias. And that's how I stay active, it's pretty fun. So one might say getting healthy foods is very difficult and time consuming, and I agree, which makes it a lot harder as the fast food restaurants out in like in every single corner. I put that there so that. So I suggest that you buy groceries to start off your week and prepare your meals throughout the week. And just keep it frozen and then pull it out and make your meal. And also, if you can just work out at home, you'll need to get a gym pass or go to school to work out. So I explained heart diseases, then I explained type 2 diabetes, and finally I gave you guys a solution to maintaining a healthy lifestyle. So I showed you why I believe that living a healthy lifestyle will only benefit us and make us less vulnerable to these type of diseases. And I guess I'll end it off by just saying that I have an uncle who has diabetes. Anyways, I've seen his struggles and I wouldn't want to go through the same thing, so that's why I'm kind of strict on myself, and yeah.